I want to talk to my empaths today. So if you're not an empath, keep scrolling. This is really for those people who are extra sensitive. And with the holidays coming up, I want to address something with you. I'm going to guess that you make excuses and hold space for people who really don't reciprocate, right? Those people you haven't seen in a long time or who you haven't seen in a long time and maybe you're really not that fond of. Maybe they're not that kind to you. Maybe you are doing something because it's what you've always done. It is a routine. Those friends get together, and even though I'm not in touch with that person, but the rest of the group is, I'm going to go, and I'm going to hold in and hold down my discomfort. I want to talk to you. I hold space for a great many people, especially my clients, right? I want to make sure that they know that they have a safe environment to express themselves, for us to do the healing work and digging deep and getting into that soul and spiritual level of things. But sometimes it's okay to be surface. You don't have to bring your whole self and share your whole self with someone who doesn't deserve it. So here's an option. If you're going someplace with people and maybe they're not your favorite, and maybe if more than half of them are not your favorite, do you have to go? You could set a new boundary and a new standard for yourself in self-care and getting through the holidays by just saying, no, thank you, I'm busy. And maybe if you don't have plans during that time, you can be busy just taking care of yourself. Maybe feeding yourself well, or going for a walk, or hanging out with your pet, or talking on the phone with someone that you actually love and loves you back, or likes you and you like them back. An old friend or a new friend. Old friends don't make good friends, right? Like, I know people who've been in my life, as I'm sure you have, but it's okay to outgrow them. If they can't hold space for who you are and have empathy for who you are and maybe what you're going through and try to have a conversation with you, why do you have to show up and be in their space and pretend everything's okay? You don't have to. You can genuinely like someone, and then maybe they like you too, but you both don't have the capacity to meet each other where you're at. You don't have the capacity to have more than a surface level friendship. And as an empath, that might make you feel lonely, excluded. It might make you feel like, what is wrong with me? But really nothing's wrong with you. Do you know that feeling? Like, if you know that feeling of kind of feeling other in a group, leave a comment. If you know the feeling of holding space for someone, but they don't really do it reciprocate, they don't reciprocate, leave a comment. I want to have this conversation with you. Yeah, it's okay. Everyone has these moments. Some friends are really old and long-lasting in a lifetime, but it doesn't mean that in every point of your life you connect and can understand each other. It's okay to take a little space or breaks. I mean, I prefer communication around that, but sometimes communication won't work because whatever you or your friend or relative is going through, you can't relate. Or it becomes toxic, or it's like something that they must struggle with on their own. Think about that one. And then you can meet again, right? I tell people a lot that it's called growing pains for a reason, and I really wish that they didn't hurt so much, but it's true. Growing pains can hurt. It can be sad and lonely in those moments. It can be confusing. But every time you get through, there's something better waiting for you. We don't come into this life to be stagnant. I think you're going to miss many lessons and joys if you do that. We come into this lifetime to experience things. If you believe in karma, to make up karma. If you believe in past lives, maybe to fix connections. If you believe in soul groups, is to encounter and help other people that you know on a very high spiritual level. Learn a lesson that their soul wants to know. They want to know what it feels to be human and have these brief lives and these intense emotions. Right? So if you're dousing yourself, making yourself smaller, dumbing yourself down, or you're holding space for people who are not capable of doing that for you, it's okay to put them in a further ring of friendship. Like I like to say, there's close rings and then they go out and out and out. And it doesn't mean that you don't like those people further out. It's just you're less intimate. I just got back from a trip from Korea, and what I really love about what I learned there about their friendships is this, that they have a lot of acquaintances, Korean people, but if you become a friend and that becomes family, and that's when you share a lot of information and go deep and know more and get involved with each other's families. I think that's kind of an interesting concept. I think when you meet someone and you think you have something in common and you kind of fall in love, or you have that haze of commonality, you might not take off your rose-colored glasses. And you might think it's forever, this friendship, but it could be for, right, that phrase, a time, a season, a reason. And then you're meant to learn something. But let's get back to the holidays. If you're an empath, and you can feel things in a room, and you're going into the room very heightened, maybe you are meant to host the holidays this year, and you know all that energy is going to come into your house, I highly recommend grounding, getting outside, touching the earth. I know it's cold and rainy in many places, but really getting outside and breathing fresh air can make a huge difference. Take a few deep breaths. Remember, you don't have to invite people you don't like into your house. You can set boundaries. You can leave a room when they start talking about something. And you can also set an end time. Hey, everyone has to be home by 9. My doors, you know, I don't want anyone in the house after 9. I'm going to be tired. It's okay to do that. So why don't you tell me, let's have a conversation again in the comments. Like, what is it that you want help with maybe as an empath over the holidays, or something that you do that really works for you? And let's help each other out. All right.